The first boss of Battletoads and Double Dragons is a Bobo. A Bobo smashes through the door, and a Bobo is ready for action. But you know, this is Battletoads and Double Dragon, where one of the strongest things you have is your flying dragon kick. So, you know, just keep jump kicking him in the face, or in the chest, and just finish him off so hard he flies off the ship. The next boss is Blag, or Big Blag. Whatever, it's Blag. So, Blag wants to stomp on you really, really hard, or, you know, hit you with their tail. You want to just, you know, jump, kick them some more, and maybe throw them, and then, you know, hit them in your knee. The next boss is Roper. Roper is actually very dangerous and actually a hard boss, but, you know, you can just kick him and, you know, crouch kick and stuff. However, if you screw up your combo here, he can easily hit you with his gun. And if he starts loading up his gun, you want to duck super quick. Otherwise, he's going to unload bullets on you. And you will, like, most definitely die. So, yeah, don't do that. You can also do an air crouch kick. It only works in, like, super 2D parts. It's weird, but useful later. The next boss is the Rat Ship. Yep, we're playing a shmup now. So, the first part of this, it just shoots its turrets, and you need to destroy them a few times before it moves on to the next part. Now, one thing about these sections is you could shoot bullets, or you could actually do a lock-on missile by holding the attack button and moving the cursor, which is, you know, it's very strong. It'll destroy something in one hit. So for this, you want to be careful, because it's actually kind of hard to dodge this attack if you're in front of it. Same thing with this. Well, not as much. I like to use the missiles. So anyways, the missiles also like missing a lot. I guess that's where the missing missiles come from, so, you know, fucking whatever. Anyways, so now they start shooting asteroids, or rocks, or waste, I don't know, garbage. And they're not hard, but it can be a little random at times. Now you want to be very careful once you blow up it for the last time. So now it's going to start shooting out these plasma things, which have very unpredictable movement and can very easily hurt you for quite a lot of health. It's easy to die in this fight a lot, so you have to be very, very, very cautious. So, once you break the last one, you start the Rat Ship starts shooting its side gun, which is actually very, very accurate, but it seems like there's a little safe spot. And after that, it'll shoot these homing missiles, you know, kind of like ours. And yes, it will kill you if it hits you in one hit, so... yeah, but once the Rat Ship is exploding, you're safe. You can touch the missiles, do whatever you want. The next boss is Robo Manus. So you can actually also do a glitch kill on him, which I'll show after. So Robo Manus just kind of moves his head up and down, just, you know, vibing. And we come in to ruin the day. I'm not sure who's driving this missile anymore. Autopilot. But if you let Robo Manus hit the ground, Robo Manus will shoot lasers in, like, pew, pew, pew. So you gotta be cautious and jump over, duck, whatever. Yeah. Overall, Robo Manus isn't that bad. But it is easy, to screw up your combo if you're just going for the jump kick, 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 kick. And, whatever. Anyways, you could beat Robo Manus. Or you could do the glitch, where you get very, like, specifically in front of him and, like, kick him, and he can't, as you can see, he's stuck. He thinks he's still driving, but, I guess we destroyed his internal brain processing chip. He doesn't have enough blast power, okay? So, as long as you don't move forward, you won't actually activate the boss fight, and with good timing, you can just keep hitting him, not taking damage, and ending the fight this way. Sometimes, though, it's a little hard to activate it this way. But yeah, you don't gotta do it. Just wanted to show it. The next boss is the Shadow Boss. This motherfucker is hard. So, he will constantly try to ram you or punch you and just bash your brains in. After a specific amount of hits, which he will do the same every time, you can count the hits, he will go into a spike ball. This spike ball will most definitely kill you if you do not grab onto one of these, like, lights. And if you break the lights, they will be gone, so you'll be fucked. So don't break them. The way he works, though, is it seems he's position-based, so every time you're really far away from him, he will always, like, guaranteed try to shoulder ram you, which is the easiest thing to get hit by. And if you miss any of your attacks and you're really close, he will almost always punish you with a good punch. But if you have quick movements, you can just, you know, use the arcade boss rule where you move up and down a lot. This works in a lot of games that have this style, of course. So, yeah, it's good to note. But yeah, hey, if you manage to beat him without actually taking damage, good on you, just like me. The final boss is the Dark Queen, who's actually very simple, but also really fucking annoying and hard. So, all you have to do is hit her. Constantly. Every time she comes up from the fire. She'll try to lob a fireball at you. Sometimes she'll either do it from up high, down low, or medium. And here's the thing. Her AI is very, very, very smart. The movement of the fire on the ground, it will almost definitely hit you. Like, when you go to jump or dodge it, it can almost perfectly follow you, and it's just so fucking hard. And sometimes she can even wombo combo you, where she'll hit you with the fire, and then the moment you come up, she'll pop up and throw a fireball at you. It's really frustrating. This is the first time I've actually managed to not ever get hit by her. So, yeah. It really does help, though, if you get lucky to get an invincibility power-up from the power-ups. But the power-up things, the little containers, they're extremely random, and sometimes you just won't get, like, anything to show up. You can also abuse the downward crouch kick in the air, which is weird, but it definitely helps in this to avoid the queen's fire on the ground. Because this mistress, you know, we ain't taking her shit. We're sending her packing, okay? So which boss was your favorite and least favorite and why? Leave a comment down below. I mean, if we're gonna not say the Dark Queen because horny. Seriously though, my favorite boss is the Shadow Boss. I always thought he was cool growing up. I mean, yeah, edgy, spiky, muscular dude, but I thought it was a good fight, even if it's really fucking annoying and very hard to not take damage during. And my least favorite boss, honestly, is Roper because it's so easy to fuck that fight up and get hit or... It's just a time waster with getting, like, trying not to get shot. Plus, Roper's stage can be a pain in the ass. Sadly, outside of owning this on the SNES, I don't really know any other way of playing it. I know there's an NES version, and I forgot if there's a Genesis, but anyways, I would love if they, like, re-released, like, a Battletoads / Double Dragons collection, which I don't think they've done. Or, of course, you know, just put this on Nintendo Online. You know, that would be phenomenal, because this is one of my favorite games of all time. And it's fun with two-player. Fun to troll each other. Anyways, if you enjoyed the video, consider leaving a like and subscribing. And of course, if you didn't like the video, you could dislike this and flying dragon kick me off a spaceship. And honestly, I can't breathe in space, so that's really bad. Anyways, hope you guys found this video helpful, informative, whatever, you know, all the fun stuff. And I'll see you guys in the next video.